Hi, in this video we're going to be looking at the BREWHA 950 liter or 8 BBL cold liquor tank. First we're going to be looking at its features, what makes it unique. Second we're going to be looking at how to install it, and then third how to operate it. So starting off by looking at the features, first off it is a pretty typical cold liquor tank in that it's able to hold a large volume of water. It is jacketed, which means that the chillant from a glycol chiller can run through it, or as is the case for most of the BREWHA customers, you'll be using our water chillers, which have a closed loop glycol loop into a water bath, and then the cold water from the water bath goes through and will cool this down. And it's also insulated, so it can hold on to that cold water and maintain it at a cold temperature until it's needed later. Most of the BREWHA customers are going to be using tap water for post-boil knockdown, so getting the temperature of boiled wort from 100 Celsius or 212 Fahrenheit down to yeast pitching temperature. But in some situations, customers may not want to use water to do all the chilling. This may be the case if if there's a shortage of water, or if the tap water is not quite cold enough in order to bring the temperature down quite low enough. Then tap water can be run through the jacket of the fermenter until it gets down to about 90 Fahrenheit or 30 Celsius or wherever makes sense, and then switched over to a cold liquor tank in order to finish that off. So that's the typical use of a cold liquor tank. Features of the BREWHA tank that make it a bit unique. We've tried to make it as compact as possible. We've also put casters on it, so of course you're able to move it around in the small space that you might have for brewing. You're able to position it by the tank that needs cooling and then push it out of the way when you're done using it. So this helps minimize the footprint in your brewery that is necessary. Second of all, we have a two-zone cooling. This just means that you can connect two water chillers to it and have them both cooling this volume of water at the same time, and it will reduce your overall chill time. Of course, one is all you need to use to chill the water that's inside down, but if you want to speed it up, you're able to do that. And we did that by adding a barrier in the jacket. Right down the middle, you can see this plate that goes all the way down on this side and all the way down on the other side. We'll get into how to connect the water chiller during the installation or operation when I talk about that. And then the third main feature is that we have a distribution plate, a custom distribution plate that we built that goes on the inside. When you're returning water, which comes from the cold liquor tank through the jacket of your fermenter and then goes back and it's been heated up, you don't want to be introducing that back into your cold water reservoir and just mixing it with all the cold water, because then naturally the cold water in here is going to warm up, and you get faster cooling if you maintain a high temperature differential. So you want all the water in here to be as cold as possible right to the very end until it's all used up. So we've installed a distribution plate so that when the water is returning from the fermenter, it stays up on the top, and then it keeps the stratification that occurs naturally in water. If it goes in and is maintained very still at the top, then as you're pulling cold water out of the bottom, that hot water stays up at the top and doesn't mix and warm the rest of the water up. And we've done tests that show that that is actually the case. So you get your full volume of water. If you've chilled it down to 5 degrees Celsius or 40 degrees Fahrenheit, you're able to be running that and using that to chill the entire volume of cold water. So that's the basic overview. We've got a lid that can securely attach on top, so if you're moving it around, you're not going to be spilling out. Moving on to installation, we have the casters down at the bottom. Of course, those need to be put on. You can lift the tank. Forks can go underneath the bottom support there and raise it that way, or you can use your hoist to carefully lift it and attach the casters. Then there's an elbow and a pipe which comes from the bottom outlet. It's a bit of a conical base at the bottom so that all the water goes down to the middle. You attach your elbow down there, then a section of tube, and then a valve. And that just brings the valve out to the outside here where it's easy to attach a hose rather than having to go to the bottom of the tank there. You can see that on the dividing wall here, if you can imagine that there's a jacket and then a layer of insulation, in the jacket it's split right down in here. So you have this side and that side. And we've got then ports. We've got the ports into the jacket on both sides, and they're the mirror of this. So this port is the entry point for the cooled water going into the jacket on this side to chill it, And then on the opposite side, there's an exit port here. So if you've got your chiller positioned on the side of your cold liquor tank, out of the pump of the chiller that BREWHA sells, you'll run your cold water into this. It goes into the jacket all the way out and then out the port at the top on the other side, back to the water reservoir of the chiller. It just does closed loop that way until you get your volume of water cooled down. Same is true for this side. You'll input from the chiller pump you have on this side. You'll go into the bottom port that's on the opposite side. It comes through the jacket and then out here and back to the water reservoir. There's two temperature sensor ports, one on either side here, and those are for operating the circulation pumps if you're using two different water chillers. If you're only using the one water chiller, then you only need to use the one temperature port. This is the return back into the vessel itself. So you take water out the bottom, cold water, you run it through your fermenter, and then from the exit, the jacket exit, you'll run it back into here, and it goes into the inside, and there's a 90 degree elbow which you attach just to, and position it up, and it just means that the water going in there agitates the water inside the tank very little, and then we have a distribution plate that's underneath that to further still the water so that it keeps that temperature stratification. There's a couple of ports on the top. If you're going to be closing it, you don't need to for any reason, but if you're going to, make sure that you use a pressure and vacuum breaker, because with rising and falling and heating and cooling water inside there, the levels are going to change, and so you're going to be changing pressures inside there. So make sure that you install a vacuum breaker or just leave them open. You have a filling port and then a pressure relief port. So for connecting, then the installation and use. When it comes time to chill down your fermenter, like I said, you're going to be running, most customers will just use tap water and run it into the jacket in their fermenter with the big tanks, like the 7-barrel tank that I'm standing beside here. You might be using a separate plate chiller as well, just to reduce the chill time if you want. Some customers with the 7 will do that, some with the 5, and then most other customers will just use the jacket for the entire chill time. Run tap water through it. And then once you get it down as low as you want to get it, when you want to switch over to this tank, and 30 Celsius or 90 Fahrenheit is an appropriate point to switch over, and that should work for most customers, then you will just use your pump. You can use the brewing pump that BREWHA supplies with their BREWHA kits, and you will connect the inlet from the bottom of the water coming out of the tank here into the pump, and then from the pump into the jacket. And then the return from the jacket goes into the return on the cold liquor tank. Pretty straightforward. You want to throttle the flow of the pump to approximately about 20 liters per minute, or about 5 to 5 or so gallons. That's going to give you maximal cooling, and it will bring the 7 barrels of hot wort from 30 or Celsius or 90 Fahrenheit down to yeast pitching temp, standard about 20 or 70 Fahrenheit, in about 40 minutes, 30 to 40 minutes. And so just that flow rate, you don't need to blow through the water, you know, too fast. That pump can move, the commercial pump that we sell can move a lot more water, move it a lot faster, but you only need to do about 20 liters. So just close that valve, and you can monitor the flow level until you become more familiar with the flow rate on the valve and where to position it, just by using the flow meter that we have. And there's the digital display that you can purchase with them as well, and they're on the accessories page of the BREWHA website. And you can just time, you know, every minute you should be looking for about 20 liters, and close that valve a little bit or open it, depending on whether you need to speed it up or slow it down. So that's a basic overview. If you have any questions, feel free to send them to us on the website using the form, the contact us form on the website. Thank you for watching.